Hello, in today's video, we will learn in detail about ecological succession. By the end of this video, you will have a clear understanding about characteristics of ecological succession, basic types of succession, difference between primary and secondary succession, significance of biotic succession, and finally about hydrosphere and lithosphere. Let us start with the introduction to ecological succession. Ecological succession is the process that describes how the structure of a biological community evolves over time. It is the steady and gradual change in a species of a given area with respect to the changing environment. It is also known as biotic succession. The first community to inhabit an area is called the pioneer community. The last stable community in an area is known as climax community. The transitional communities are the intermediate communities between the pioneer and the climax community. The entire series of communities is called sphere. Let us look into the different types of spheres. Hydrosphere, succession in an aquatic habitat. Xerosphere, succession in a dry habitat. Lithosphere, succession on a rock surface. Samosphere, succession on a sandy region. Halosphere, succession in saline soil or saline water. Next, we shall learn about the characteristics of ecological succession. It is a systematic process which involves change in species structure. It leads to an increase in the species diversity. It moves towards state of stability. It leads to an increase in organic matter and biomass. It also helps in the development of soil and its humus content. Succession of plant and animal communities occur due to change in physical environment and population of species. Next, let us get an idea about the basic types of succession. Among the various types of succession, the two main types of succession are primary succession and secondary succession. Primary succession or perisphere starts in the area where no living organisms ever existed, such as bare rock, newly formed pond, etc. The secondary succession or subsphere starts in an area which has lost all forms of life that once existed. For example, land affected by flood, an abandoned crop field, etc. Another type of succession is the autogenic succession, in which the vegetation modifies its own environment, resulting in its own replacement by new communities. In allogenic succession, the replacement of the existing community is caused by some external factor. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share the video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Next, let us look into the differences between primary biotic succession and secondary biotic succession. Primary succession starts from barren, uninhabited land. Secondary succession occurs in previously inhabited or recently denuded, disrupted, or disturbed region. The region in primary succession lacks soil and organic matter. The region in secondary succession retains soil and organic matter. Primary succession is relatively slow and takes over 1,000 years to complete. Secondary succession is relatively quicker and takes short time, about 50 to 200 years to complete. In primary succession, it is very challenging for the pioneer community. In secondary succession, surviving plants easily grow to form a pioneer community. In primary succession, there are many intermediary cereal communities. Very few intermediary cereal communities are seen in secondary succession. Initiation of primary succession usually occurs either due to biological factors or external factors. Initiation of secondary succession is always due to some external factors. Next, we come to the significance of biotic succession. Biotic succession or ecological succession is responsible for the growth and development of an ecosystem. It initiates colonization of new areas and recolonization of the areas that had been destroyed due to certain biotic and climatic factors. Biotic succession helps in maintaining a specific biotic cereal stage. Dams are protected by preventing the siltation and checking biotic succession. Reforestation and afforestation can be done successfully. Let us learn about hydrosia or hydrarch succession. It involves ecological succession in the newly formed pond or lake. There are different stages in hydrarch succession. First is the plankton stage. It is the pioneer community of the hydrosia. The plankton stage mainly includes the phytoplanktons like diatoms, unicellular or filamentous algae, cyanobacteria, etc. The zooplanktons feed on the phytoplanktons. Death of both phytoplanktons and zooplanktons produces organic matter which mixes with the silt, becomes soft and fertile, and favors the growth of next cereal stage, namely rooted submerged stage. The rooted submerged hydrophytes such as hydrilla grow and are anchored in the mud. Due to their death and decay, organic matter goes on gathering under these plants, raising the bottom and increasing its fertility. Next is the rooted floating stage. It is formed by hydrophytes like nymphae, pistia, lemna. They add more dead organic matter that raises the bottom further. The pond becomes more shallower and turns into a marsh, favoring the next stage. Reed swam stage. It is also known as the amphibious stage. Most parts of these rooted plants remain exposed to air. Example, typha, polygonium. These plants lose a lot of water by transpiration, and their death increases the amount of decaying organic matter. This brings about a change from marsh to soil and favors the sedge meadow stage. Plants like cypress, carex forms a mat-like vegetation with the help of its rhizoids, causing the disappearance of marshy vegetation and resulting in sedge meadow stage. Next, woodland stage. The shrub plants like cornus can tolerate bright sunlight and therefore invade the peripheral area followed by trees, example almus. Mineralization and soil favors the arrival of the next stage or the climax stage, that is the forest stage. It is a climax community. The type of trees depends on the climate of the region. Example, tropical rainforest develop in the moist tropical areas. Coniferous or deciduous forest grow in temperate regions. Succession of plant communities is accompanied by a corresponding succession of animal communities. Let us summarize hydrarch succession. Hydrarch succession occurs in areas where water is present in abundance. It begins with small phytoplanktons, followed by submerged and free-floating plants, and then rooted hydrophytes, sedges, grasses, scrubs, and finally the trees. The transformation takes place from a pool of water to swamp, then marsh, and finally mesic conditions. Let us see the lithosphere. It is a type of xerosphere and involves the ecological succession on bare rock surface. Various stages are as follows. Crustose-lichen stage. It forms the pioneer community, example, graphis, rhizocarpon. As we all know, lichens are resistant to desiccation and temperature extremes. They produce organic acids, cause withering of rocks, releases minerals essential for growth of lichens. This favors the arrival of foliose lichen. Lichens like Parmelia, Dermatocarpon retain more water, accumulate dust particles, help in the development of soil layer on the rock surface. This favors the growth of mosses. Mosses grow extensively, example, polytrichum. Death and decomposition add minerals, add more soil and organic matter. Increases the thickness of soil, fertility and water holding capacity. Next is the herb stage. Annual grasses start growing. Roots penetrate deeper, causing mold, withering of rocks. They replace the mosses and change the composition of soil. They are replaced by perennial grasses, example cynodon. They add to the thickness and fertility of the soil. Next is the shrub stage. With the accumulation of more soil, the habitat becomes suitable for shrubs like Zizipus, Caparis, etc. They replace the grasses and herbs. Their dead, decaying leaves add organic matter and makes the soil more fertile. Finally comes the forest stage. This is the climax community in Lithosia. The vegetation finally becomes mesophytic. The type of climax community is determined by the climate of the region. Rainforests develop in moist, warm tropical zones, and coniferous or deciduous forests grow in cool, temperate zones. Succession of plant communities is accompanied by a corresponding succession of animal communities. Let us summarize Lithosia. It begins with the growth of lichens on bare rocks. They produce acids which dissolve the rocks. This brings about withering of rocks, resulting in soil formation. It is then replaced by mosses, followed by herbs, shrubs, and finally trees. A stable climax community evolves, leading to mesic conditions. So today we have learnt about ecological succession in detail. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comment section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comments section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.